भीमातीर निवासाय पंडरीपुर वासिने पांडुरंग प्रकाशाय विठलाय नमो नमः। मरुत्पुत्राय कवये भीमाय भयहारिणे श्रीमद आनंद तीर्थाय प्रख्याताय नमो नमः। डियर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ गॉड, जय श्री कृष्णा, नमस्ते। टुडे इज द 17th डे ऑफ द नेशन वाइड लॉकडाउन। व्हाट इज द प्रेडिकमेंट ऑफ द मॉडर्न मैन? ओवरव्यू इट, लुक एट द फैमिली अराउंड हिम। ही इज गेटिंग वरीड first about their welfare, his own health, his own profit and loss, his monthly budget, his children's future, his own future. There seems to be no silver lining. And the disturbing news of the candid news channels, the vivid pictures of disease and the committed doctors who are trying to cure it, everything is making him tense. We are lost in our own thoughts. Our plans seem to have no meaning. Our future is bleak, no, blank. Stress is increasing. Hypertension is under control with multiple tablets. The best food tastes insipid. The entertainment channels do not really entertain. They actually bring you back to brass tacks and you are at your wit's end. Oh no, do not drink or smoke. There is a simple panacea for stress. A very simple universal panacea. All the stress is because of the emphasis on the pronoun I, my family, my business, my health, my money, my losses, and so on. Turn the emphasis from the pronoun I to they. Look around and see those who are in a worse condition than ourselves. Remember the quote, I cried for shoes until I found a man without feet. When you shift the emphasis from I to they, this is de-stressing. You have an objective view of other people's suffering and the subsequent response is something heartening. You are planning for someone else. You have taken out something for someone else. You are concerned about someone. You are free from the shackles of selfishness. Your BP will be normal. You will sleep without tablets. You will have absolute peace. Let us think of helping those who need help. And Lord Krishna stands behind you to help you. Give a morsel and gain a barrel. Give a drop and gain a gallon. The thought movement from I to they, helping the helpless, the suffering, the hungry and the elders, that very thought raises you to a different orbit and you find that you have become an angel in disguise, breathing the air of paradise. Your mind has no stress now. Your hyper-planning mind is planning to help others. The difference between worrying about oneself and about others is like the difference between carrying a mountain and a feather. When you think of others, the great God is just behind you, guiding you on the path of service and love. Take on the burden of others and you will see a thousand-armed God is standing behind you to hold your burden. Give the thirsty a glass of water and the clouds will water your hectares of land. Look after a poor child in your neighborhood and your offspring studying overseas will be in God's safe hands. One night I was stuck in the traffic in Mumbai when it was raining for 20 hours. I was in the car. All along the way, rich businessmen and their spouses were offering me fresh Jain food, hot coffee and tea, and call me mother with love and care. We were in our NGO looking after 1500 people's hunger, and the Lord was looking after my hunger on the way to the airport. My tear-filled eyes thanked those love-filled hands. In crisis, don't sit and brood, send messages of love and concern and serve as much as you can because there is no other way to de-stress yourself. Tere aansu ko poochne aaya bihare kahe ko man ghabraye kahe ko man ghabraye kahe ko dil ghabraye tere aansu ko poochne aaya bihare kahe ko man ghabraye। थैंक यू।